Hello, everybody. Today, we'll be talking about the environmental impacts of shrimp aquaculture here in Asia. Presented by Sean and Dorothy. When we go to a fresh market here in Hong Kong, we often see shrimps being sold at different prices, and they're coming from many, many different places in the world. And these places include the following.
Close to 80% of the total production of shrimp in the entire world came from Asia, and Asia has been called the cradle of aquaculture because it is the place where the culture of fish in freshwater began in about 500 years BC. And in recent years, due to increasing demand of the subsistence farming methods of old were rapidly replaced by the more productive practices. Traditional methods were replaced by so-called extensive farming, compensating for low density with increased pool size. Instead of ponds of just a few hectares, the size increased to up to 100 hectares. The culture of shrimp is basically a two-step process composed of a broodstock hatchery phase, producing seed, or post-larvae, and a grow-up phase, usually in earthen culture ponds, for ongoing or fry to marketable size. Nonetheless, the dramatic failures of shrimp farms in Taiwan, Thailand, and many other Asian countries in recent years have raised concerns about the sustainability of shrimp aquaculture, as well as the environmental impact it has on the environment. First of all, mangroves. Mangroves are useful in many ways. It produces various goods, including charcoal, firewood, construction materials, and fishing materials. In addition to that, it also acts as a buffer zone, providing coastal protection during typhoons and storm surges. However, many rank mangroves in Asian Pacific regions has been removed because the land has to be used for agricultural purposes, especially for aquaculture farming and shrimp farming. Moreover, the release of saltwater from shrimp ponds has caused salinization of agricultural lands. For 45 hectares of once productive rice, and also shrimp farms in central Thailand have become an ecological desert because of that. The breaking of coastal embankment in a surge for seawater has led to the salinization of rice lands and a drop in rice production in the last 10 years in Bangladesh. And then comes the problem of water pollution. Intensive farms, unlike traditional farms, they need large amounts of feeds to support high densities of shrimp, and flush correspondingly high loads of waste into coastal waters and cause serious water pollution. They also increase the level of nitrogen and phosphorus and other water quality parameters in the water. Last but not least, the growing interest in shrimp farming has been accompanied by numerous transfers and introduction of adults and larvae of these preferred species, mainly in the Indo-Pacific region. The introduction of these species arises a major concern, which is associated with the widespread of viruses. And it also causes high mortalities in the shrimp farms. To remedy the current situation, there are different recommended actions that can be taken to promote long-term sustainability in the industry. First of all, we can help ensure optimal sustainable use of coastal natural resources, including the maintenance of high levels of biodiversity and real conservation of critical habitats by coordinating the initiatives of various economic sectors. Second, we can protect and restore mangrove habitats and wild stocks. Of course, at the same time, we have to manage pond effluents. Legislation and regulation will also help solve the problem. And of course, regional cooperation will also be very important in helping promote long-term sustainability in the industry. We hope that this video can help you learn more about the situation of aquaculture of shrimp farming here in Asia, its impact on the environment, and how we can promote long-term sustainability in the industry. Thank you very much for listening. Goodbye.